Introduction to the Siglent Oscilloscope, Part A. For this, we will use a function generator and the Siglent Oscilloscope. We will connect the devices with a BNC cable, also known as a coaxial cable. Connect one end to the input for channel 1 on the oscilloscope, also known as the X input. Be sure to push it all the way in and then turn it till you feel it click into place. If you don't get a secure connection, you will have a poor signal on your oscilloscope. Connect the other end to the output on the function generator. Again, be sure to push it in and then turn it until you feel it click. Turn on the oscilloscope. It's a computer and it'll take a moment to boot up. Turn on the function generator. At this point, you should see a signal of some sort on your oscilloscope. If you don't, try adjusting the trigger knob, and if that doesn't work, call your instructor over. When using a digital oscilloscope, it's a good idea to start by pushing the default button. The settings that were used last time are often left inside the oscilloscope, and pushing the default button can save you some confusion sometimes later. There are 4 buttons on the function generator. For the things that we are going to be doing in the labs of this class, these buttons should be off. Out is off. These 3 buttons determine the type of signal the function generator is creating. The first button is a sine wave, also known as AC voltage. A function generator in sine mode acts as an AC power supply. This is the symbol for an AC power supply in a circuit diagram. The next button outputs a square wave. A function generator in square wave mode can be used to mimic a charging and discharging RC circuit. The last button is the sawtooth wave. It's not generally used in the physics introductory labs. Select a sine wave for this activity. These buttons are used to control the output frequency. So you select the button to choose the range of frequencies. We are going to start with the 500 Hz range, so that way we're selecting frequencies between 50 and 500 Hz. You can adjust the output frequency with the coarse and fine adjust knobs here. Select a frequency somewhere between 3 and 500 Hz. Use this knob to adjust the output voltage. Adjust it to about halfway. The function generator is providing the signal that we're going to measure with the oscilloscope. Once we've set up its values, we don't want to change them. The oscilloscope is then going to measure the signal that's put out by the function generator. The oscilloscope is like a graph measuring voltage along this axis and time along this axis. we can compress or expand the display using the horizontal or time adjust knob. Turning it counterclockwise compresses the timeline, and turning it clockwise stretches the timeline. The vertical or voltage adjust knob stretches and compresses the vertical axis. Here on the left side, you can see a little ground symbol. That's where the zero for voltage is measured from. The ground adjust knob, located here, can adjust where on the screen the ground is displayed. As I adjust the location of the ground voltage, notice the signal moves up and down on the screen. The trigger knob is one of the most important knobs on the oscilloscope, and sometimes just blindly turning the knob can help stabilize a messy signal. The location on the oscilloscope graph for the zero of the time axis is indicated by a blue triangle at the top of the oscilloscope. The location of the zero voltage on the oscilloscope graph is indicated by a yellow triangle at the right side of the oscilloscope. At what voltage the signal crosses the zero time axis is adjusted by adjusting the trigger. Adjusting the trigger knob is now changing where the signal is drawn on the scope. If you adjust the trigger to a voltage outside of one of the voltages of the signal, then on some oscilloscopes the signal will disappear. On others, the signal will just freeze. We want to know the frequency of this wave. Newer scopes like this can just tell us the value, but we're going to do it by counting divisions and multiplying. First, I want to stretch out the wave as much as possible to get one whole wave on the screen. Notice that this is not quite a whole wave, but almost. So I'm going to adjust the time setting to show more waves. I want to measure the time from where it crosses the zero voltage line while increasing to the next time it crosses the zero voltage line while increasing. We can move the whole signal left or right using the horizontal or time position knob. I'm going to measure the wave from here to here. I could have also measured from peak to peak or from trough to trough. I'm going to use the horizontal adjust knob to move the beginning of my wave to a convenient crossing place, right there. Each box is a division. I'll count the number of divisions between the beginning and the end of the wave that I'm measuring. Multiply the number of divisions times the time per division listed right here, and that will give you the period, and then 1 over the period is the frequency. Another way to measure the period is by using the blue triangle here at the top of the screen. Use the horizontal adjust knob to put the signal in the middle of the screen. Also, make sure the trigger is adjusted so that the signal crosses the zero voltage line at the blue triangle. This number right up here should read zero. I want to go from where it crosses the zero on the way up here, and then go to the next part where it does that, and move it left. So I move the signal to the left, the horizontal position knob. Okay. After I've moved it one whole wavelength from where it was, you'll notice that the blue triangle has also moved, and I can read right there how far it's moved. That value is the period of the wave, and 1 over that is the frequency of the wave. To measure the peak-to-peak voltage, I adjust the ground so that the bottom of the signal touches a convenient line. I want to know how many divisions it is from the trough up here to the peak. It's helpful to move the peak to the center line where it's easy to read the markings. Then count the divisions from trough to peak. Finally, you multiply the number of divisions times the volts per division, which can be found right there. A modern scope will measure the peak-to-peak voltage and frequency for us. Start by pushing the measure button. We're displaying channel 1 right now. If we had more than one signal, we might need to change this source button to channel 1, but it's already there in this case. If we push the type button, then we see an array of choices. To scroll through the choices, we use the intensity knob to select the column and the trigger knob to select the row. Once we have made our choice, we push on either of the two knobs we were using to toggle on or off the measurement. Push the type button again to remove the menu. The measurements that you've selected can be read here near the bottom of the screen.